The box and block test measures unilateral gross manual dexterity. Patients are seated at a table, facing a rectangular box that is split into two compartments of equal dimension by means of a divider, which should align with the patient's midline. The block should be in the compartment ipsilateral to the evaluated side. In other words, if I am to perform the test with the right hand, then the block should be in the right compartment. Typically, the number of blocks is either 150 or 100 as it is in our case. Importantly, these blocks should be of 2.5 centimeters in size. The blocks should be scattered randomly within the container, with no more than two blocks stacked on top of each other. The distribution should be loose and varied, avoiding perfect alignment. In other words, each block's positioning should ensure some degree of separation, helping patients access individual blocks easily, without having to maneuver around tightly packed stacks. The patient is instructed to move as many blocks as possible, one at a time, from one compartment to the other for a period of 60 seconds. If you intend to perform the box and block test for both hands, then start with the less affected side first. If there is no clearly affected side, then start with the dominant side first. To administer the test, the examiner is seated opposite the individual in order to observe test performance. The starting position of the patient's hands should be to the sides of the box, and only once the you give the GO signal the patient should start. Give the patient a 15-second practice, which is not scored. We recommend to use the instruction ready, go, instead of counting 3, 2, 1 go, as patients may already start moving at 1. The box and block test is scored by counting the number of blocks carried over the partition from one compartment to the other during the 1-minute trial period. Patient's hand must cross over the partition in order for a point to be given, and blocks that drop or bounce out of the second compartment onto the floor are still rewarded with a point. Multiple blocks carried over at the same time count as a single point. Higher scores on the test indicate better gross manual dexterity. Sometimes patients may not be able to perform the box and block test unilaterally, meaning with just one hand without any help of their healthy side. In these cases, the score of the box and block test is 0. We recommend to always perform standardized box and block test even if the person is not able to perform it. Additionally, to the standardized box and block test, you may perform a modified version of the box and blocks test. Here are some examples which would require a modification of the test. The patient suffers from severe spasticity and requires their healthy hand to open up their affected hand. In this case, the patient can use their healthy hand to open up their spastic hand. This also constitutes a modified box and block test, and you could note down how often and after which number of blocks this stretching occurred. The patient has some residual distal movement, but has insufficient shoulder function to move their arm from one compartment to the other. If the patient is lacking shoulder function, one may perform the box and block test in a standing position if the patient is able to stand. However, even this modification still requires some shoulder function. Another option is for the patient to lift and move their affected arm with their healthy one. Finally, the scores you obtain from these modified versions should never be compared to the standardized box and block test as they were obtained under vastly different conditions. Our box and block test is available on Amazon. Go check it out if you are interested in buying our handcrafted premium quality box and block test.